Thanks for clicking on to WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Derek Weglar. It is a cloudy day as expected for most of us across the state. You really had to go to the seacoast to find any sunshine, at least early. Temperatures are in the 70s statewide, and the dew points are so much more refreshing from this time yesterday. We're into the 40s and the 50s. That's helped hold a lot of the rain off initially for most of the state. That being said, there are rain showers up north, mainly in Coos County as expected. You see some of the steadier rainfall moving through there. It's been light. It's not a washout by any stretch, but there's more moisture lurking upstream here. You can see the clouds are persistent through much of Ontario. So this has to go south and east into our neck of the woods going forward. So it's still cloudy overnight tonight, still cool too, which should set us up for a nice night. And the rain showers will persist mainly north on Sunday before another cool stretch next week. So we'll call it the lower to middle 50s north, near 60 though, point south tonight. And you can see the rain begin to move through. Initially, this is the first batch as we go towards sunset tonight. There will be more after midnight as we go into early tomorrow morning, mainly north of, say, Franconia Notch. So Conway, Whitefield, Berlin, you'll see some light rain continue. And this will be on and off through much of the day. There could be some sunshine around noontime. Really tough to promise this when it's been so cloudy, at least near the grounds, the last 24 hours or so. And the rain may even get heavier as we go towards Sunday evening and even mix with thunderstorms along the Canadian border. So we'll call it for the upper 70s, at least for Concord, point south tomorrow. A little bit cooler towards the north. This is Hurricane Ida, has really strengthened here as we've gone through the day today. The eye now becoming more visible. You can see that there, sustaining winds of 100 miles per hour. So the track from the Hurricane Center will take Ida basically at or just west of downtown New Orleans as a major hurricane. This is Category 4 with sustained winds of 130 miles per hour and make landfall sometime Sunday evening on the parishes that border the Gulf of Mexico. But again, the track has been towards the east, so New Orleans is in play here for a direct landfall at this point. Weakens rapidly as it moves towards the northeast here. And you'll notice the cone now begins to inch its way closer to southern New England. So we're anticipating moisture from Ida to move its way north at this point to give us some rainfall as we go into Wednesday and Thursday. This isn't a massive amount of rain, but it is a decent amount of rain, mainly from Concord Point south to the Mass border. So it's very much confined to southern New Hampshire as we go into Thursday. Cooler, though, for the end of next week, highs in the middle 70s.